James, and we're back. We're back in the Superstition Mountains today. We're here to take a look and see what kind of devastation we have in the Woodbury Fire. Now, the great news is me and James were back in it today. We were out in it today. We're on first water. Peralta's open also. And so we're going to make a loop back to Canyon Lake and go down to Fish Creek Hill and see how far we can get in down there. The great news is, though, it's back. And so some of the great Superstition Mountains are open, which is awesome. Great news, right, James?
Right.
So we're happy to be here. And so let me take you on the journey to see what's open in the Superstition Mountains.
Don't worry about it.
Did you get a free hat with those shoes?
I didn't. Saucony didn't hook me up. Hint, hint, Saucony.
Saucony didn't hook him up. So we're going to go back up to the trailhead. The only person we've seen out here is the forestry service. That's the only person we've seen out here on the trail so far today. But man, it's damn good to be back in the Superstition, James, isn't it?
It really is. I'm excited.
So here we are, Fish Creek Hill. Guess what, James? Closed. You know, I was told it was closed, so I'm not completely, I'm kind of astonished that I could get here even, right? That we could get here. Now, the road's completely closed, so up to Fish Creek, so, you know, Apache Lake, it said Apache Lake was open on that sign, though, but they've completely closed Fish Creek Hill. And that's why I'd love to get down in, because I want to see down in that bottom where the bridge is, you know, what the devastation is. Now, we're going to go back. Now, we've come up this, and what we found out is the south side of this route is looking pretty bad, isn't it, James?
It is.
It's looking terrible. So, you know, one sign is that the cactus are better than I thought they would be. You know, hopefully they can come out of this. So maybe the heat didn't get as intense over on this side as it did the back side. One of the things we talked about was that a lot of what we thought would be burnt was not burnt. Right? I mean, we thought that, you know, there'd be more of it burnt than there was. You know, I mean, it doesn't negate the, you know, the fact that it is a terrible tragedy, but it wasn't as bad as I personally thought it was going to be. So what do you think, James? I mean,
I'm bummed we can't go any further down the road today. It's really nice to be back on the Apache Trail loop. We were set off our course for like 2 months. But, I mean, it's nice to see that, like, the whole place isn't burned down. When you hear the numbers of 130,000 acres of 166,
right,
in my mind, because, you know, I just assume, like, oh, the whole thing is going to be pretty devastated. But even some of the burned areas we saw, it looks like saguaro survived. It looks like some of the prickly pear, ocotillo,
right.
Some of that stuff looks like it was a lot of just the grass. I'm not going to say just the grass. I mean, it's devastating, but it looks
could
like
be worse.
It's going to come back.
Yeah,
it
could be
it
worse.
It looks like it has opportunities,
you know,
to come back.
The only thing that might be interesting, too, is, and when I say interesting, is to look out for, is if we do get the monsoons, you know, what type of vegetation, how much water will destroy, because there's no grass or anything holding the
erosion.
You
know,
erosion, exactly.
Yeah.
So that's the only thing we'll be able to have to take a look at. Flash floods might be worse in this area
that's
this year,
true.
As they possibly be. But, you know, there is Fish Creek. If you're familiar with it, there it is. You know, how devastating is this, really? I mean, it really is. You know, as you walk along the road and you look up in the hill and, you know, you just see, you know, I mean, the desert's got its own kind of beauty that's a little different than what most people believe that is, you know, what's beauty. But I mean, to see this like this, I mean, it's almost devastating. It's almost heartbreaking to see, you know, And it's one thing also if it's a natural act, you know, if lightning strikes, because that's something that could have happened for hundreds of years. But, you know, when it's negligence, you know, on somebody, I mean, it's pretty damn sad that this is, you know, this is what we get. You know, the thing that also scares me is when the monsoons come, you know, how much erosion will be here because there won't be any plant roots to hold the soil, what's left of it, here. And we're at the Tortilla Trailhead, and I tell you what, it's a pretty sad state. You know, all we can hope is that, you know, it comes back, and it comes back quick. One thing that's promising is that, one thing about the desert, if it, you get water, something will grow. There's an old saying that a cue ball will grow hair in the desert with enough water. And hopefully that'll be true and this will come back. You know, what scares me or bothers me is some of these cactus, for example, that are hundreds of years old. I mean, they're living legends. I mean, they saw the stuff happen in here. They saw the Dutchman come through here. They saw the Spanish come through here. You know, they saw that. They're living remnants of our history. And it's just sad to see some of these, you know, some of these cactus have been here 200 years. And, you know, those are things that can't be replaced. I'm sure the brush will grow back, but, you know, it's just sad. It really is. And again, if it's Mother Nature, that's one thing. But for it to be some type of man-inflicted disaster, I mean, look at this. I mean, it's just sad. It really is. But, you know, we can hope that it grows back. And, you know, one thing that we said is look at this ground now. So if you were looking for if you were looking for some type of cave, some type of place where maybe there is the Lost Dutchman gold, look at it. I mean, all of a sudden you don't have anything in your way. So let's go to this side of the road just to show you. So you come over here and you look at all this growth. You know, it would be extremely difficult or impossible to see something that would be down here, right? But if you go over here, there's what you got. So if there was any reason, there's any plus at all, and it really isn't a plus, but you know what? If you're going to hike the Superstitions and look for the Lost Dutchman gold, you would have to agree, James, this would be the time to do it, right?
I think so.
Because look at that. There's no brush in your way. I mean, even through here, if you look down here, where you wouldn't have been able to see down in this area, for example, I mean, you can see everything. It's all gone. So we've got back from, we're heading back from being out at Superstitions. What do you think, James?
It was interesting. I mean, we definitely saw some of the damage done. We went as far down an Apache trail as we could. Finally found the road closed sign right after, or right at Fish Creek Hill.
You know, it's, God, it's pretty ugly though. You know, I tell you, it is ugly. And, you know, I was really pleased that a lot of, what I thought would be burnt was not burnt. And so, you know, they did a pretty damn good job of at least containing a lot of that stuff that, you know, I thought was gonna be gone. I really thought by the time that Tortilla Flats, we hit there, I thought we'd see just devastation. And we didn't really get into that until we got almost to Fish Creek Hill. So there was a little bit on the right-hand side, which would be the southern side.
Yeah, the Tortilla Trailhead.
Yeah, and all the stuff on the north side, they did a great job of being able to stop that fire along that road and keeping it from jumping over. But yeah, I'm more worried about, you know, now that there's nothing on the ground to be able to, if it does rain monsoon-wise, I'm just thinking the erosion could be terrible, though. Really could be.
Oh, definitely could do more damage. The roads could definitely get messed up, so we'll have to wait and see. Monsoon's been kind of weird this year. We haven't gotten too much, and it's already August, so.
Well, one thing I can tell you, though, is, you know, it's going to be nasty hiking when we get in there. You know, we could tell by just what we walked through already, it's really going to be dirty you know, it's going to be filthy. But you're going to be able to see. You're going to be able to find stuff. I mean, there's going to be, you know, the vegetation being gone. You know, if there was ever a time to be able to get in there and be able to give it a good shot at seeing if you couldn't find the treasure, this would be the time to do it. You agree with that?
I do agree, yeah. They definitely cleared out all the grass and brush and stuff. We couldn't really get down and see what, like, Fish Creek's like or anything, but...
Well, I want to ask everybody at home, I mean, what do you think? You've seen the video by now. You've seen some of the drone stuff. You've seen some of the stuff where we were at the Tortilla Trailhead. You know, looking at that versus one side of the road versus the other side. You know, what do you think? I mean, what do you think about this? What do you think about the possibilities of being able to get in there? Who's coming out this year? How many people are going to give it a run? How many people are going to give it a shot? This would be the year to do it if you're going to do it. But what do you think about that? Please subscribe. Please hit that like button. And please share this if you possibly can. It would definitely help us out. Help James out, right?
Definitely. Give us a little thumbs up.
Thumbs up. Bing, bing, bing. Myths, legends, and lies on the trail of the lost Dutchman. Is he really lost?
Maybe.